Hello dear friends, in this video we will learn to use the area effector in detail. Really any effector that will add a nice aesthetic to your game. And you will learn all the details of area effector in this video. Okay, let's get started. I've created a simple scene to focus on the area effector. I've created a new object called effect zone and added a sprite to this object. We will add area effector to this object. I also added a ball to this scene. The ball has a rigid body and collider. It also has a script named ball. This script has only one task. When we press the spacebar, it will bring the ball to the starting point. I added physics material for the ball to bounce when it hits the ground. Start the game in this case. As you can see, no force is applied to the ball in this case. I want force applied to the ball while the ball is in the area. First, I'm gonna add box collider to the effect zone object. And then I'll add area effector 2D component. As you can see, there is a warning on the area effector component. For this effector to be active, we have to check the box used by effector on the collider component. And it's triggered too. Okay, the area effector is ready. Let's test it. Start the game. As you can see, the force was applied to the right, while the ball was in the effect area. The component is currently at its default values. We can change the direction and strength of the force applied to the ball. Let's get to know the properties of the area effector component and customize it. We can change the magnitude of the force that will be applied to the ball. Let's change this value to 0. As you can see, no force was applied to the ball. If I set to 10 again, the ball will move. You can change the magnitude of the force as you wish. I will set the force magnitude value to 10 again. With force angle, we can change the direction of the force. I wanna set the direction of the force upward, so I will set the force angle value to 90. As you can see, the force is applied upwards on the ball. I rotated the object 45 degrees. To show the difference between the local angle and global angle, I will click to here to see local angle. This is local angle. And this is global angle. Currently, the force is applied according to the local angle. If I set it through the use global angle, the force is applied according to the global angle. If you use the local angle, the force direction changes automatically when you change the direction of the object. With collider mask, we can specify on which layers the effect will be active. Currently effective on all layers. I will check the layer of the ball. The layer of the ball is default. If I remove the default from the collider mask options, the area effect will no longer take effect on the ball. If I choose its default layer again, it will affect the ball. If I disable use collider mask feature, it will take effect on all layers. Let's get to know force variation, another feature of the component. We can apply a random force with force variation. I wanna show this with example. For example, let's set the force variation to 20. In which case, a random value between 0 and 20 is added to force magnitude. Finally, a random force between 10 and 30 will affect on the ball. Let's look at another example. As you can see, a random force between minus 5 and plus 5 is applied to the ball. I'll set the force variation value 0 again. And set the force magnitude to 10. If I give a negative value, then force is applied in opposite direction. Let's get to know drag and angular drag. I wanna show this with example. I duplicated the effect zone object. All three objects are selected and drag values are 0. I released the ball from the starting position with the spacebar. As you can see, the effect area couldn't hold the ball. Let's increase the value of drag and see the change. You might think we are changing the density of the effect area with drag. As you can see, the ball rotates freely. We can limit the rotational movement with angular drag. Let's back to the game making process. I have created a game object named Area Effector. This game object has a box collider and Area Effector component. Additionally, I created a particle effect like this using the particle system. Start the game. As you can see, the Area Effector is ready. You can customize it according to your game. Now, I'll create a prefab from the Area Effector. So, I can quickly use the Area Effector I have prepared whenever and wherever I want. I hope the video useful for you. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.